flooding the market, a break from the garbage. An artist, sensitive about mine, pardon. No margin for error, flawless beware. The black cat goddess, you walking with a panther. Painting these pictures with words like Samantha MacGyver. Alchemy on the track, make it lava. And I won't stop rocking till I retire. Single or plural, she make numero uno. Colder than you.
I'm Mad Money, aka Trap. And welcome to the official Sony Game album review of Vic Spencer's Psychological Cheat Sheet 2. Make sure you hit that like button, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and let's get it. Now, Vic Spencer always is putting out work. Last year, he gave us the first part of the series, Psychological Cheat Sheet. He gave us Spencer for Hire 3. He also gave us No Sean Shrimps. I can never pronounce that right. And his last project to end out the year last year was Rather Be a Real One, which was a direct to fans type of deal. And that's what I like about Vic, you feel me? He's always open to his fan base and always trying to do things just to let him know that it corresponds with them. A lot of artists do not do this for whatever reason, but Vic, he's not on that wave. This project was exactly produced by August Fanon. And I want to let you know right now, like, I really, really like the production on this. I was not familiar with August coming into this, stepping into this. But I'm excited to see more work from August Fanon, just from the production alone. Because when you have an artist like Vic Spencer, right? Because Vic is crazy to me, right? He has these elements where he, you know, he's playful on tracks. He could get serious on tracks. He lets you know his mind frame around things. He lets you know how he truly feels about issues and anything. Little issues, big issues, all of these things on here. So when you have somebody like that to work with one producer that could build that world around you, you did a good job. You feel me? That's just what it is. First track on here, 14 Days at Grant Hospital. Dope beat. No nigga around me is bumping y'all music. Y'all niggas clueless in this rap shit. My shit stay exclusive. And this is that, like, that play into, like I said, that direct link to his fans and stuff like that. Because even though you might say that that's not exclusive, that's very exclusive to be able to talk to your fans and have your fans be interactive with you. That's something a lot of artists don't do. So I'm taking a high road on that, Vic. You feel me? Because I know how you could get. I know what this means on here. You feel me? But I'm taking a high road on that. All right. Next track on here, Vision Wear. And this is drummy beat on here. Been through hell so long, heaven gave me a pass. I hate the devil with his negative ass. And it's just like, yo, Vic reminds me, like, Vic will say something so out of the ballpark sometimes. Like, he reminds me of, like, Redman in that respect, even though it's not, you know, it's not the same thing. But just that element of surprise and just say some shit like that. Like, I hate the devil with his negative ass. Like, you feel me? Just how he says it on there. Really, really dope stuff. Next track on here is The Unforgiven. 17 blunts for my 17 fans. This is what I'm saying. Like, he's letting you know, like, you know, Vic, you got more than 17 fucking fans. Let's go. But just something like that. Just that realism involving that funny type of stuff that be going on here. I really appreciate that. 17 blunts for my 17 fans. Spit more 16s than I could hold in my hands. And he always talking about fist fighting a nigga too. I appreciate that. But like, you can go into gunplay, but he tell you he will beat the brakes off of you with you. Do you really want to fight me? Do you want to see these hands, jerk? So it is what it is on that. Next track on here, this might be my favorite track on here. I got a couple favorites, I ain't gonna lie to you. Hades Was a Hoe. And I know just from seeing the track listing on here, when I saw Hades Was a Hoe, that it was gonna be something crazy. And it starts off crazy. It's a Biggie reference just straight off the rip in this, which I appreciate that. It's like this smoked out jazz club beat on here, you feel me? And it got a crazy beat switch on here too. So just really, really dope. I really do appreciate that track. Next track on here, Rehab Resort Part 2. Knowing my ribs glowing when I'm blowing on Piff. And it's like, he's giving himself these, like, with these like qualities, these like superhuman qualities. Like he smoke a joint, he start glowing. You feel me? He got the glow. He's on you and shit like that. Really, really dope. I really do appreciate what Vic brings to the table on here, because it's not orthodox, and he has an unorthodox way about him, but he knows that line. You feel me? He knows how to play into that line. So I really do appreciate what Vic Spencer brings to the table all day. Next track on here, Drunk at 2:43. And this has this like, I don't know if it's PM or AM, but probably PM knowing him. He has this like big band sound going on. August has provided this big band sound on here where he's just, you know, he's letting go. He's talking his shit. He's drunk at 2:43. Why argue with a bitch when she look like Chewbacca? Like, yo, these are the type of things that just come out of left field on you. Well, I appreciate Vic. And he like keeps you in tune to the lyrics and what's going on, because he'll say some off-kilter shit any given moment, dog, that makes sense in the whole shit. So, next track on here, Reciprocate the Love. Wouldn't know you if I wasn't rapping. When you in your own lane, there's no traffic. And he goes in to talk about social media tactics and all this stuff on here. I appreciate that. When you in your own lane, there's no traffic. You feel me? Dope shit. Because he knows his lane is not ordinary to what is what goes on in the underground. He comes across really, 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 really different. Next track on here, Norbit's Revenge. How many rappers got their ass beat on camera and ain't fight back? How many rappers got their ass beat on camera and ain't fight back? This is this review's question. Make sure you answer Vic Spencer's question on Norbit's Revenge. How many rappers got their ass beat on camera and ain't fight back in the comments below? You hear me? This man is crazy. Next track on here, Horns in the Cornfield. He gives you like two flows on here. And this is where his dexterity comes into play out on here. And beat switches. Like, that's what I said. What August is able to do on a album called Psychological Cheat Sheet, you expect it to be these things going on, you know, because ain't nobody straight, anybody normal, you feel me? So it's going to be these things going on. And August, he really does provide this platform for Vic that just let Vic be Vic. You feel me? Really, really dope stuff on here. I'm going to tell you too, Vic bends the second half of this track. Just to let you know that. Next track on here, Sneaker Bandits. Rocking on my shit till it's rotten. It's crazy, right? Because I know Vic is a sneakerhead and stuff like that. So he's talking about like vintage clothing from the 90s on here, clothing, all of this stuff. But then he says a track, like a line on here, rocking on his shit till it's rotten. And it's like, you know, you're talking about the one who is not, like, doing the same thing. I really did appreciate this shit, to be honest with you. Next track on here, psychotic panhandler, all right? Look, and it's like these little joints on here that just let you, like, into Vic's mind. So he's constantly battling on this album too, where he's trying to be good and then he be bad and then he be good again, you feel me? So he's working out his demons on this album in a real light way though. Like, you know what I mean? It's not heavy, but it's like, be out here crying for Vic or anything like that. It doesn't come across anything like that. You feel me? But it's these little tracks like A Psychotic Panhandler that just lets you into his mind. And again, that just plays into what August brings to the table here as well on production. Next track on here, Victor Winslow. It's a storytelling track about riding on niggas. Like, this is what I'm saying. When he's dealing with these things and stuff, like, you know that, you know, he's street, but he's not your average street cat either. I do appreciate that. Bipolarism is the next track on here. And he's talking to himself. And this is where these things come into play. Like I said, letting you into his mind. What's going on over here? What's going on over there? What's happening here? And like I said, August just provides a perfect backdrop for him on this. Last track on here, Green Thumb Theories. And it shows off all his characters and his personalities and stuff like that. Vic is something else when it comes down to it. And I think that if you're not familiar with Vic Spencer, this project in particular is a good introduction to just his world, what he gets into, what he really does. Like, I think that this is like a perfect intro album to Vic Spencer if you're not already aware of him. Like, I got introduced to Vic Spencer on Spencer for Hire 3, and that's a whole different type of thing than what actually goes on here. This is him being his truest and doing what he does the best on Wax right here. So make sure y'all check it out. If y'all listen to it, let me know what is the best production on this album, what's the best track, what is some of Vic Spencer's bars that just like throw you off, you'd be like, what, like, huh, you said that? Let me know all of that stuff in the comments below. But I'm about to get out of here. I'm Madam Money. You can follow me on Twitter and IG at Madam Money Says. That's MadamMoneySays, and as always, I'll be seeing you guys around. Peace.
Target. I'm flooding the market, a break from the garbage. An artist, sensitive about mine, pardon. No margin for error, flawless beware. The black cat goddess, you walking with a panther. Painting these pictures with words like Samantha MacGyver. Alchemy on the track, make it liver. And I won't stop rocking till I retire. Singular or plural, she break numero uno. Colder than Juno.